up there, do you think? The new Empress?
She came in a few days ago, but she keeps to herself. Must be a shock.
I wonder what she's like.
Just a kid, I guess.
Imagine being a kid. Then suddenly, they tell you in a few years, you'll rule the Empire. What do you do?
Me? Settle a few scores, I guess. Then order some pastries from that shop on Clapper. Lots of them.
Thank you. least.
Samuel, a useless old man, hungry for purpose. Couldn't be with us. Unjustly dismissed from the name over an affair of honor. My friends, the times we've had. I'm almost sorry this moment. This is all Martin's fault. We hadn't helped Corvo get out of prison. Corvo hadn't been so damn good at his job. We hadn't gotten greedy, afraid. If. Always too sure that was my problem. Never hesitated. Too sure of what I wanted. Too sure of what I wanted to do when other men stopped to consider. Saw it as a weakness. I know Corvo's coming for me just like he came for the others. Crossing the island below like it was nothing. Only a question of how and when. I'm lacking a counterman. It's all fallen apart. All the steps that led us here made sense. When I was young, I went to sea, took command of a ship, and made aimless men into sea, made a collection of boats into a navy, then founded a conspiracy and almost led an empire. No compromise. Never showed mercy. Never showed weakness. I showed the world what mattered. Will and vision. And not being afraid of getting dirty. And now, I'll lose it all to a man with a faster sword hand. Or is it that he has a slower sword hand? There's something wrong with the world. It'll make a good story for the history. I'll have a good epitaph. In his time, he commanded a noble lord, a high overseer, and an empress. The man who brought down a tyrant, Admiral Havelock. Son of the high ocean. Did you think I'd fight you, Corvo? Sorry to disappoint. This is yours. The key to Emily's cell. She'll be glad to see you. You made quite an impression on her. Did you know that? She asked about you constantly. Where you were. What you'd been doing. I told her. In the end, I told her everything. From the start, when we had such noble goals in mind. To the end, when we were afraid, fighting in secrecy about who we could trust and who we had to kill. Arguing over who would act as new Lord Regent. And she listened, eyes wide. She's become an interesting girl. If she lives, she'll make a memorable empress. Go ahead. Kill me or take me to Coldridge Prison. Make your choice. She'll be watching.
Guards! To me!
Admiral Havelock?
If you don't let me out, I'm going to make you stand in a corner until you learn how to behave. Corvo? Who's there?
Such things, cowardly things that I'm ashamed of. How could anyone ever forgive us? Would they? Even if things are better? No, that's not how it works. Once the bureaucrats step in, everything gets muddy. If anyone ever knew, we'd all lose our heads for this. So no one can know. And could we ever control Emily with Corvo around? That's the question that sticks in my mind.
We need to make our final move,
and we need to make it clean.
Only a few in the know.
The ones with the most to lose.
Is it going to be okay now? Will I be Empress?
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. And decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.
Oh, long enough for all of the big and the small, where the taller they stand, where the harder they fall. We live for today, but we die for the next. With blood in our veins, in the air, in our chest, or we step into war with our hearts on the line. The dirt on our boots, it shakes free over time. The music, it waves, the violence slows. The darkness, it rises as the sun goes. Love is a distant aroma at best. A withering smile that's stuck deep in your vest. The night air, it wraps its fingers around your body, it shakes from a now distant sound. Oh, the sound of her voice, a sweet symphony, played over and over until you are free. Brought the disease.